All right, we are live. Welcome to the fourth Phys Ed Summit hosted by ESPEChat. My name is Matt Eichel and I'll be your moderator today. As always, we'd like to thank the Phys Edagogy crew for creating the Phys Ed Summit and helping ESPEChat along the way. So today we're using technology and during the session, it might go wrong. I've already had to buy a new keyboard today, so yes, technology can go wrong. We're using a new chat feature this year, which is called Padlet, to help us communicate. If you have any questions or comments, please use the chat feature on the Padlet wall. Miss Stephanie Saldino will be there, and she will be able to get me your questions. And to access the Padlet wall, you need to go to the ESPEChat website, which is espechat.weebly.com, and click the button that says chat for the session that you are attending right now. In the event that the technology fails, we'll use Twitter and update the website as quickly as we can. We'll also have to update the ESPEChat web page as quickly as possible and send out notices about where a new room may be if technology fails. If you're using social media, please use the two hashtags, hashtag ESPEChat and hashtag Phys Ed Summit for your posts. All right. So today we have with us from the O'Hare Airport in Chicago, Melinda Wilson. She's going to be talking to us today about active citizenship in phys ed and dance. And I'm just going to pop up her PowerPoint presentation here. And she's going to take it away.
Great.
There you go. It's all to you.
Thank you so much. Hi, everybody. Hi. From O'Hare Airport. I'm heading out in about an hour, so it's great to be part of this Phys Ed Summit. So welcome. Go ahead, Matt. We can change the next one. Thank you. Yep. So on the next slide, you can see, go ahead, Matt. There we go. So we're talking about today the power of active citizenship. And right there's the Twitter, it's Performers for Change. And on Instagram is also Performers for Change. And please feel free to follow me. This is really important because I'd also like to start working with everybody out there regarding active citizenship. I think together we can all do something that's interesting and powerful with our students. And if we can all get together to do something, it would be even better. Thank you. Next one. My name is Melinda Wilson, and I am from Chicago Public Schools. I'm an instructional specialist, dance specialist, working with other dance teachers from across the internet and the district itself. We're the third largest district in the nation. I'm also a 2017 Shape America Dance Teacher of the Year and the 2018 International Top 50 Teacher, as well as a Varkey Ambassador. I also work for UNESCO and Center for International Dance out of Paris. Right there at the bottom, I don't know if you can see it or not, it's orange. But if you need to reach me, you're more than welcome to email me at melindawilsondancer@gmail.com. Also there, you can ask for any lesson plans that I have, and including webinars and PowerPoints regarding the things that I'm going to be talking about. Okay. All right. Going on. Today, we're talking about the power of active citizenship. And what you're seeing here is something that we put together in June. You know how it is right before school ends. The students are antsy, so to speak, and they really don't want to be in school. So what the students decided is after the shootings in Florida, we had a lockdown at our school. And the problem is we didn't know the lockdown was over. And we stayed in my room and we had a little closet. There was 45 of us in this small closet. We were there for over 3 to 4 hours. And next thing you know, we hear people in my room and the kids started crying. So I walked out the door and realized that it was just a drill. We had no idea. And the kids said, let's do this, Miss Wilson. Let's do a flash mob regarding school safety. And I thought it was an excellent idea. So the students and I decided to do a flash mob. They chose the music. There's three different sets of music that we use, three different choices. And from there, we also, the students decided they wanted to pay homage to the students who had been massacred. So in the photo that you see, you'll see there's photos of students who were massacred in different school shootings. They also decided to go from Columbine all the way to 2018, to the end of last school year. And what they did is they came up with, unfortunately, enough names to fill four pages. Okay, so we're gonna go on. And what you're gonna see next is, this is the YouTube video that we sent to the United Nations. So if you would like to play that, Matt, that'd be great. If we can get a hookup on that one.
All right.
Thanks. This was student produced. Matt, it's the other one. This is the other one. Thanks. This is the last one. Sorry, guys. There it is. Thanks.
Tolerance. Tolerance is the ability or willingness to tolerate something, in particular the existence or opinions or behavior that one does not necessarily agree with.
Acceptance. We have so much non-acceptance in the world today. We have so much violence and killings against each other. And we just accept one another in today's generation. We come as one and love each other and be there for one another.
Love. There is nothing more important than love. Love is the motivation of life. Martin Luther King once said, darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that.
Kindness takes a big toll in society today because of so much going on in the world. And we should be kind to one another on a daily basis. You will never have a bad day if you show kindness to one another.
Thanks, Matt. I like the sharks. All right, so what you saw there at the end, those were all the students' names. We had a group of students who researched all the names and put them in there. And while we were working on this, the Texas shooting happened as well. So we're trying to make sure that everybody, including everyone around the world, understands how important our students are, and that these students that went to school should be, this should never happen, let's just put it that way. So we live in a world with profound diversities, all of us, and no matter where we teach, you can teach in Winnipeg, you could teach in Florida, you could teach anywhere in the world, and we still have challenges. We're looking at economic development, obviously health and welfare, environment, education, international peace, and improvement of human dignity and understanding, which are really, really important. So we're gonna continue on to the next one, the next photo. Okay, great. So this is really important to me. When you look at your students, no matter what age, they can be elementary, high school, middle school, there's this energy there. There's energy and education and vitality and enthusiasm of our students that can and will move the global community to focus on issues of common concerns and seek solutions to the most important problems of our time. So if you look at these students in the photo, these are Chicago Public School students, and they're brought together to perform, so you can see their faces. When they have a say in what is produced and they get behind it, there's all this vast energy that just comes out, and it's amazing. So as teachers and perhaps administrators out there, we can all utilize that energy and to be for positive outcome. Okay, next slide. This is a project that we worked on last year. It's regarding human trafficking awareness. It started out 2 years ago. I've been choreographing for a theater company called Her Story Theater. And all of our students in most of the classes at the school, our school houses about 3,800 students. I was lucky enough to get approximately 500 students to this show. And what it did was the professional show that they went to told a story about a girl who had been trafficked and how she had been trafficked. It was just one of the stories out there. So my students knew of a child who was a Chicago Public School student who had been trafficked and who lost her life from the John she was seeing on Christmas Eve. It was very difficult for them. So what they decided is they wanted to create a human trafficking awareness project. And this is what they did. Last year we put on this, and originally it was for the school itself, since we have so many students of student body. And you're looking at trafficked victims. Trafficking victims a while ago, let's put it that way, used to be starting at middle school to high school. It's changed incrementally as we've gone on, unfortunately. Be that it, as it may, after the dramatic play, the students wanted to pay homage to this child who was killed by this John. So they went to create awareness for the other students at our school. And eventually it grew to other communities. We went into the suburbs to present it. We also went to a professional theater in Chicago in the city, so the members of the city and the suburbs could also see it. We also had police officers, teachers, and other students from all ages that actually watched we called it an informant. So the next one, please. So the students that you see here in this next photo, this is the active citizenship used through informants created by the students. So we called it an informants because it's more about information and informing people about what's out there. So up on the top, you can see all the visual art that was presented, the posters. What you don't see is actually stickers that we were giving out. And we were also putting them, since our school district is along a major freeway where people are trafficked, because the airport is rather close. We actually put stickers out on all the trees and by the motels and with a hotline. So if people were being trafficked, you could actually see the 1-800 number and the students could get help. So we did spoken word, and this is the one you probably can't see. It's not a very good photograph, but that's the one with the balloon. And there's a child behind the balloon and, well, a student of mine. So the students would memorize stories, true trafficking stories, and they would sit with the red balloon and they would say their story. And after the story was finished, they would pop the balloon. That was spoken word. The students also created a poem. We had visual art that you can see up there. We had song on the students on your right-hand side. They created a beautiful song. We had dance. We also used technology and social media to get the word out. We used drama, performance art, and also graphic design, and that's what you see at the top with the graphic design. So it was a difficult subject, but the students did an amazing job. We don't have a video on that, and that's on purpose, because when you're working with students who are so invested in it and know people who've been trafficked, we decided not to put together a video. But what we do have, if you want it, I have got a PowerPoint on it that we use through the show, and I've also got curriculum through all different subjects, physical education, English, civics, science, dance. So if you're interested in that, just let me know and just email me and I'd be more than happy to share that. So the next slide we're going to go to is really, really important. And thanks, Matt. These are the 17 goals to transform our world from the United Nations Sustainability Development Goals. These are extremely important. I didn't even know until last year that these existed. I had no idea. I started doing more research, and the Varkey Foundation actually helped me embrace these and taught me what these are. And I didn't realize, but all of us, no matter where we teach, we are doing this regionally in our own schools. So we're going to look at all the different options here. And these are the 17 goals through the United Nations. We're looking at no poverty, zero hunger. I know our school has a free hot lunch program, and we just started last year a breakfast program as well, which has fruit and orange juice and different healthy items for the students besides just bars that they can purchase. This is one for all physical education people, good health and well-being. This is our middle name, being physical education teachers. Quality education, again, as a teacher, we all supply great quality education. That's what this whole ESPEChat is about. Gender equality, we all teach this in our rooms as well. Clean water and sanitation. This is more important in other areas than others, but it's really important, clean water and sanitation. For example, I know in a lot of schools we had to shut them down this year because there was asbestos in the walls and it was getting into the water lines. So very important. Affordable and clean energy, decent work and economic growth, industry innovation and infrastructure, reduced inequalities, sustainable cities and communities, responsible consumption and production, climate action, life below water, life on land, peace, justice, and strong institutions. And that's the one you saw earlier that was the flash mob that was produced. And then partnerships for goals. And partnerships are extremely important, and that's what ESPEChat as well is doing, getting everyone together and partner up, and not only partner up with different phys ed teachers and dance teachers, but other teachers from around the whole world and businesses around your community, which are extremely important. For example, we created bikes one year for affordable and clean energy. We did an experiment on how much electricity we could get out of a bicycle. So we were actually, excuse me, I'm on a webinar. So at any rate, be that as it may, sorry guys, I'm in an airport. So we did a bicycle experiment to see how much energy we could actually put out of the bike and distribute, and it really, really worked well. And we were actually able to get enough energy to work out the entire physical education gym, one of the largest gyms that we have. And usually in that gym, there's about 200 to 300 students in that gym. So our classes are fairly large in our district. Okay, thanks. Next one. Thanks, Matt. So we're looking at collective participation. As teachers, we must prepare our students to become good global citizens. This is extremely important. Also, schools must play a prominent role in that project. So, for example, when you go in this year, and I think a lot of people are starting next week, if I'm not mistaken. I know we have another 2 weeks prior to seeing our students, but I'm introducing the United Nations Sustainability Development Goals to our administration staff. And just this week, I was in a 6-hour meeting with Chicago Public Schools Arts, and we are now including that as well in our curriculum, so, which is extremely important. And that way, your facilitators, your administration staff can see that, yes, you're doing this regionally, but also it's applicable for everybody, whether regionally, nationally, internationally, it goes through everywhere. So that's extremely important. Also, to let you know, when you're trying something like this with the students, they're gonna come up with a lot of different ideas. They're gonna use you as a soundboard, which is really, really good. If you ask me, it helps. But sometimes when students are dealing with something that's so wide and you have to actually hone them in and bring them more in their topic, there's gonna be a little bit of, the kids are going to be uncomfortable because there's a creative side to this. Kids have to deal with ambiguity as well as we do every single day. So that makes the child creative, which is really, really important. So as we deal with ambiguity, students should too. So it's not going to be a comfortable process. It's not going to start out that way. Also, as a teacher, if they decide to do a flash mob or go outside of the school, just to let you know, you may have to pull up permits for different places. Now, these are very doable, very easy. A lot of them you don't have to pull permits, but for Chicago area, we actually had to pull permits, but it was really easy. I just called the building that you saw in the first video, the Thompson Center. I called the center. It was really easy. They even gave us 5 free marshals that were watching the students to make sure everything was okay there. So they were amazingly kind and generous. And when people find out what you're doing and that the students have decided and been put their foot outward to try to change society and the community and trying to make it a better place, you're going to get a lot of positive, positive impact. And it also helps bring in businesses and community members from outside of the school and help you and support the school itself. Okay, next slide, please. So, we want to create inspirational students who will be able to face what comes their way and achieve things we can't imagine yet. It's really important. That's the next generation, are these students. They're so extremely important. And you can see different age groups in here. It's our lifeline, if you will. I teach because of the students. That's why I teach. So it's nice to create, to have students that are creative and who can think out of the box and become visionaries. And that's what the students do once you enable them to kind of find out what their aspirations are and then continue from there. Okay, next, thanks. So active citizenship, we're looking at outstanding contribution to the profession. So this is more for administration to discuss it with them, but to let them know that through active citizenship, this is your outstanding contribution to the profession itself. It's student created, very, very important. Also, teacher facilitated. So as a teacher, you have to kind of hone in all their ideas and make sure it's a democratic process between everybody involved. You're also gonna have to address the challenges and context to make sure it stays linear and consistent. Innovative curriculum. This is it, ladies and gentlemen. This is innovative curriculum. You have measurable performance outcomes. And whether we're looking at formative assessments or summative assessments, this really works well. I mean, obviously, when you saw the first one, there's your assessment and there's the students. And at the end, I've got another video, the final video, to show you what happened. So there's measurable performance outcomes automatically. You're also working locally, nationally, and with global impact, which is extremely important. Because look, social media connects our students. We're trying to develop global citizens in our students. They're already there because of the social media and how close we can contact other people from other countries and other communities and other cultures. So it's extremely important. Next slide, please. Okay, so the last thing we're gonna show you is the flash mob, which is, this is about 13-minute video, and this is the real thing that was produced. So this is the full actual flash mob that you're talking about. There's three songs. And when you see this, there's a reason there's three. The first song is to get everyone excited, so everybody can come out and just dance and do what they want. The second one, you hit them with a message. And we use Michael Jackson's song, and you'll see it. And then the last song is more about coming together and finding a solution. And what we did at the finale, and you won't see this, but at the end, all the students' names were read that have died since Columbine. And the students all sat down in three separate circles around the center with the photos of students who had been massacred at different schools. So enclosed, here you go. Here is the final video and the final outcome. And we'll talk a little bit about it when we get back. Thanks.
Hang on there, Melinda. I don't know if you can hear the volume. Yeah, I can't hear the volume here.
Yeah, there's no audio on it. We can go on if you want. That's okay. But there's a hookup. There it goes.
You got it.
I heard it a little bit.
Yeah, let's see if we can. Thank you.
So there's a reason why we do everyday people on here. So Matt,
the generations, and then say we want to make it a better place for our children and our children's children, so that they you know it's a better world for them. Think they can make it a better place.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. Was brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to wait. Well, there's no, there are ways to get there. If you care enough for the living, make a little space. Make a better place. You're the one. We will really get there if you care enough for the living.
Thanks, Matt. Mm-hmm. So it's a powerful message and it's different. It's also a positive message, which is different from forming organizations that just go and just stand and with signs and just picket different places. So this is actually a positive message that we're trying to get out. That we tried, and it worked really, really well. We performed it within an hour four different times, and each time there was about, with each time we performed, the audiences got larger and larger. So for active citizenship, you don't have to just go and walk to somewhere and join a large crowd, for example. You can actually do something that's active and interesting and bring the audience more positive information, which I think is extremely lacking these days. And to give a positive spin on things and give people hope, I think is what education is about, and making creative citizens out of our students and visionaries, and creating visionaries out of them so they will be able to succeed throughout the years on their own terms, not someone else's terms. The students that we used, actually there's four different schools here in Chicago Public Schools, and we decided to do this. The seniors were actually had already graduated, because the other students go to school a bit longer than the seniors, but all the seniors came back for this, and I was extremely proud of them, and their parents came to support, and we took four different school buses, and there was 150 people cut off, so we had 150 students there, so I was very proud of them. But this is another way to do it. Obviously, there's different ways to do it in physical education. You could do it with a basketball shootout or different things of that sort. So, but it is positive. This, the last thing that you saw, we actually sent out through Shape America videos, tutorials for other schools to join in. I know there was two schools in New York that received them, and a couple other schools that were interested in doing a flash mob. But what we're hoping for next year is to do a flash mob in Washington, D.C., and get more schools involved throughout the United States and throughout the world. That would be lovely if everyone did something on the same day with the same topic, to do something that's a little bit just positive and understanding of the world around them and really connecting it to the sustainable development goals. So if anybody's interested, we'll be doing another flash mob and we'd love to have your input. And if you have any other ideas as well, I'm always open for different ideas, and so are my students. Anything that's positive and connects students to global skills so they will be able to compete in society. Okay, questions, anyone? Oh, by the way, this is the Performers for Change, this logo. This was created by the students this year. So this is new. All this is new. The Instagram and the Twitter, this is all new. So and so if you need any, there's tons of curriculum on all of this that I've sent out. So if you'd like curriculum, lesson plans, PowerPoints regarding any of this, just email me at melindawilsondancer@gmail.com. And I'd be more than willing to send that out, and happily so. Any questions at all?
Yeah, we got one question. It's okay. Here's a question. What does the process look like in choosing these worldly issues? Do the students have a say? And is there a discussion that happens between her and her students before creating movements?
Absolutely. First of all, never do this at the beginning of the school year. that's a really good question. And this is all student created. So what happens is, for me, since I teach dance, the students come in and I'm lucky because my students, I get to see them all the 4 years of high school if they choose. If they choose to take dance, they get me all 4 years. It just depends on where their schedule is and what fits in. The level one students, I will start them always with technique for the first 3 months and then continue on with more advanced movement. But all the students by second semester, after first semester, we have a show then. And after that second semester, we sit down and we have a discussion. And the students usually bring in problems that have happened, whether it be just personally or throughout the community. In Chicago, we have a lot of issues with violence. This is a major part of our community. So the students decide, it's student driven. Everything is student driven. But what happens is, as a facilitator, as a teacher, you really are a facilitator. And you have to make sure that they stay on task and target. For example, in the human trafficking show, awareness show that we did, the students started creating a dance and they were yelling at each other and they were getting so upset because so-and-so wanted to do this move, so-and-so wanted to do that move. So I had to negotiate in and bring myself in. But it's good to watch them be uncomfortable with it and really search for what they really want and deal with team situations and deal with other students because they're going to have to do that on the outside community. And also going to university and college, those kids going outside of their communities, they have to be able to understand how to negotiate and how to deal with ambiguity. So that's really, really important. So as a teacher, I basically facilitate, make sure they stay on target. I deal with outside resources that they need and what we need to continue on to the students wanted to go outside of our community and go to a large state building. So we went to the James Thompson Center. I'm the one that helped facilitate that. So it just depends on your students and how comfortable they feel. The flash mob was actually created by the students. What I did is I basically, the students, first of all, this took, I must say, a week to decide on the music because then we had to vote. Everybody had to vote and find their favorite music. And then we all discussed it. So it was all negotiated. It's all democratic process. After that, I played the music and I said, okay, let's go. And so the students had to come up with the counts themselves. And every student came up with like four counts, maybe students who were shy, maybe two counts or so. Some kids really came up with eight counts or even a 32 count phrase. So, and then what we do is we build that and then we make a tutorial. From the tutorial, we send it out to different schools who are interested in joining us for the flash mob and what we're creating. And then they also have a say. So when their input comes back to us, that can give us more input to maybe tweak what we're doing. So it's all based upon the people who are involved. And it takes a lot of patience to work with each other. And at the end, though, it's way worth it. As you can see, the kids are very vested in it because it's their idea and it came from them. Did that help? Did that answer the question?
I think you did.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Just checking to see if there's any other questions. I think that might be our only one.
Okay.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Melinda. As a phys ed teacher and as a phys ed teacher, I teach a lot of immigrant families and who have gone through a lot of different turmoil in their lives, just being able to teach them dance and have them get out of their comfort zone and kind of present themselves. Really, that really spoke to me, which is really cool.
Great. Thanks. Thanks. Well, it's been an honor to be here with ESPEChat, and I really appreciate all your help, Matt, and Stephanie, you too, hon. So thank you. Thank you all.
Oh, yeah. Stephanie on the questions, for sure. All right. So if you were a participant today, Let's see here. Hang on a second. I'm going to show you how to get where you need to go. If you are a participant today, you can go to the ESPEChat website. You can go to the 2018 Phys Ed Summit. Scroll all the way down. And there will be right under here, Melinda Wilson, certificate of attendance. So if you want to get that, you can for viewing Melinda's session today. And let me get back to the screen here. All right. So thank you, Melinda. You can watch this session again because we recorded it and we'll have more sessions today. Just check the ESPEChat or website for that. We have four more sessions, two more in about 12 minutes or so, and then two more after that. And yeah, thank you very much, Melinda. And hopefully everybody can stay and hang out for the next 2 hours.
Great. Thank you. Have a great one, everybody. I'm going to go catch a plane. Bye.